Dominik Garcia is here with a movie that I think is going to scare a lot of us, myself included. Nice to have you here this morning.
Thank you for having me.
Let me ask you this, and this is you've worked for a long time on the Magic City show. It was a wonderful show set in 50s Miami.
1959.
Uh-huh. Yeah. And you've spent a lot of time in Miami.
Yeah, I was actually born there. My parents grew up there. All my cousins, aunts, and uncles, grandparents. They all live there, so I would spend all my summers there growing up, so it was nice to work there for a bit.
You reference your parents. Your dad, Andy Garcia, has been here on several occasions. When you said, hey, Dad, this is the thing I want to do, you're smiling when I say it, because he thought this is a great idea or this is the worst idea.
Well, you know, my parents put me in acting class when I was 5 years old.
Oh, wow. Okay.
So they did it.
Yeah. So it's their fault. You know, it was one of those things. I was a shy kid, and someone recommended that I do acting class to kind of come out of my shell. And it was something I always did as a hobby. I would do plays, and it became something that I just really fell in love with and I went to college for. And it was like my form of expression that really made sense to me. And but he really just, as long as I worked hard and studied my craft, and, you know, he was supportive. He never really discouraged us from following what we wanted to do. Yeah.
Several credits to your name, but you've never done something like this before.
Never.
And this is a question I often ask people when they're in scary movies.
Yeah.
Did it scare you to make the movie?
It didn't scare me to make it. I mean, I'm someone who doesn't really see these kind of movies usually because I get so scared.
Right.
Like with things jumping at you and everything. But what I loved about this, you know, it's sort of a throwback to more of the older psychological thrillers. It's not this gory
or like Hitchcock
horror film. Exactly. Or like The Tenant or Rosemary's Baby, like that sort of tone. And, you know, for me, it was such a challenging role, and it was actually a really like cathartic experience in every frame of the film. And it's something that I had never done before. And so it was really testing my stamina and really what I can do. And I saw it as a really amazing opportunity.
We're going to look at a clip in a second, but when they said cut rap, was that like,
Yeah. I actually got really sick at the end of the film. I was in the hospital for like four days. I had a fever, and I was just, I didn't really know that I was that sick until the end. But yeah, and then once that was done and I got back to L.A., I felt actually a bit weird. It was being in that headspace for so long and really just having one day off a week, and I would just be sleeping really in my time off. And so it sort of hit me, you know, having nothing to do. It was like, I feel a little bit weird or whatever. So, yeah, but
all right,
it was good.
Time to get look.
Are there any children here? Like a little girl, brown hair.
That's what you're looking for. It'll cost you extra, but it can be arranged. Just a little Jesuit humor. But to answer your question, no. Providence is not a place for children. You have a good night now.
Okay. I don't like the chuckling priest.
It's Raymond J. Berry. He's the best.
He's a really good actor.
Oh, the best.
Desolation hits theaters next Friday, January the 26th. Really nice to see you this morning.
So nice to see you. Thanks for having me.
Thank you.
Thank you.